What's up? It's me, Angels, from Angels Crafts and Bakes. So, today, this video is going to be sort of different. I usually get straight to the baking, but I haven't talked to you guys. Like, how was your day? How was the weekend? This weather's going crazy. It's driving me crazy. This is a new cupcake recipe I found. This is not no random cupcake that I just found on the computer like, oh, I'm going to do this on my website. No. This cupcake is famous. Famous how, you say? Well, this is from Georgetown Cupcakes. My teacher actually bought this book. I don't know if she wants her name in this video, so I'm just gonna say, hey teacher! She watches my video all day. So, this book is called Cupcake Diary from Kathy and Sophie. And today, we're gonna be making some pumpkin spice cupcakes. Guys, this is super easy and fun. Okay guys, so I'm just gonna go exactly what the book tells me. So, the things we will need is a cup, a half a cup, and 1/3 of a cup, a sifter, and if you don't got a sifter, just get a metal wick and put all the ingredients in a bowl and just whisk them until they're nice and fluffy. 1 teaspoon, 1 tablespoon, and an ice cream scoop, so every cupcake you have will be the certain amount of cupcake batter. Okay guys, so I'm gonna go exactly like the book tells me to do. So, the thing we will need is 16 tablespoons of room temperature unsalted butter. And these 6 ingredients, you're gonna sift them together, which I did, and it is 2.5 cups of all-purpose flour, 3 tablespoons of baking powder, 2 teaspoons of ground cinnamon, 1 teaspoon of allspice, 1 teaspoon of ground nutmeg, and 1/2 teaspoon of salt, and 2 tablespoons of honey, 1/3 cup of hot water, not boiling water, make sure it's hot, and I got canned pure pumpkin. You will need 1.5 cups of that. 4 room temperature eggs. If you forgot to take them out and you're in a hurry to make this, just put the eggs in a bowl of warm water for 10 minutes and it will be room temperature. And 2 cups of sugar. Let's get baking. Okay guys, so the first step is to sift your all-purpose flour, baking powder, ground cinnamon, allspice, ground nutmeg, and salt in one bowl and set aside. Okay guys, I probably forgot to tell you in the beginning of the video to preheat your oven to 350 degrees Fahrenheit. And then, the first step is to get all your butter into the standard mixing bowl, or if you don't got one, just use a hand mixer, and mix until light and fluffy. And the number one rule about this book is to never over mix. Okay guys, so after your butter is nice and fluffy, I took like 2 minutes to make it fluffy because it was ready room temperature. I already had it out. So you want to stop the mixer and add your 2 cups of white sugar. And mix on medium speed and stop the mixer and mix your other cup of white sugar.
Don't you think that it's boring how people talk?
Okay guys, so after you're done beating in your sugar and butter until light and fluffy, the other
best rule is to scrape your dough between the mix so you can get every little bit of sugar crystals into your batter. So our next step is to add your 4 eggs one at a time after each additional mix. Okay guys, so after you're done creaming the eggs with the butter mixture, what you want to do now is get your pure pumpkin, which again guys, I bought my pure pumpkin in a can. You guys can also make it or find it somewhere else fresh. And get your honey and mix both of them in a mixer in medium speed for 4 minutes. Okay guys, our next step is to get your flour mixer and your hot water, not boiling hot, and just gradually add 1/3 cups of the flour, then half of the water, then keep repeating until you left with the flour left. Okay guys, so if you put your flour and water in first, what you want to see is that if you have little flour in the corner, just stop your mixer machine and get a plastic spatula and scoop down the edges and fold it into the mixer. Okay guys, so after you're done with your cake mix, what you want to do is fill each cupcake pan with an ice cream scooper so you can level the cupcake to the equal amount they should get. Now, this recipe said it makes 24 cupcakes. Well, this big bowl, these little cupcake holes. Yes, I think it makes more. Let's see. Wanna bet? Okay guys, so I should have made the bet because there was a lot more, so I won. Haha. But anyway, wanna put these in the oven for 25 to 30 minutes. Check on the 15 mark because it could be a little cooked if your oven works faster, and put a toothpick to it. If it comes out clean, that's how you know your cupcakes is done. Okay guys, so while your cupcakes are baking, you can start making your cream cheese maple frosting. So I already add all my ingredients in this one big bowl, guys. This is a lot. So the things you will need is 8 tablespoons of unsalted butter at room temperature, 8 cups of confectioner's sugar sifted, a half a teaspoon of pure vanilla extract, 12 ounces of cream cheese at room temperature, and a half cup of maple syrup. So guys, 8 cups of confectioner's sugar. That's like the whole bag I bought, and when I measured it, that really was the whole bag I bought. And then the cream cheese was also a lot, so hopefully this comes out great for all the cupcakes I'm doing. They said to start mixing it, but I know this is gonna go everywhere. So what I'm gonna start doing is to fold this in little by little. So all the confectioner's sugar will be mixed in, then I'm gonna start mixing on high speed until light and fluffy. Okay guys, so the frosting came out too liquidy, I say. It's supposed to be like that, but it came out like this. So I'm gonna put the wrap over it and put it in the refrigerator for 30 minutes and see what happens. Okay guys, so this is technically the finishing product because the frosting came out too liquidy. I put it in the refrigerator for a good hour. Then I tried putting it in the freezer for another hour, but it still comes out liquidy. And don't even bother trying to pipe it because it was just turned flat like these did. So I'm doing this new thing now where I rate my baking and crafting to see how easy and yummy are they. So this one, I would give this pumpkin spice recipe a 5 out of 5 because the cake is so delicious, but the frosting is not. If you ever use this recipe like I just did, I would rather change the frosting a little bit, add a little less cream cheese and a lot less powdered sugar to it. So see you guys next time.